Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears.
What?
The hearing video.
The hearing video.
If I were to ask you what you would rather keep, your eyes or your ears, you'd probably choose your eyes, right?
Yeah, right.
Guess what? Scientists argue that you should choose your ears. Ooh. Surprised?
Yeah.
You shouldn't be. Listen. Layers of sound, yet each one is distinct, offering an incredible amount of information. Actually, more information than your eyes. So it's worth keeping your ears in good working order.
Sounds are all around us. We hear many different sounds every day. Some sounds are pleasant. Other sounds are unpleasant.
Everyone knows this appliance makes noise. It's loud, but not too loud.
It seems bearable, even at frappe. This is really, really loud. So loud, in fact, that if I wasn't protecting my ears, my hearing could be damaged permanently.
But did you know that could damage your hearing just like... Now, how can that be? How can hurt you like... Well, we're gonna find out.
The middle ear is connected to the back of the throat by the eustachian tube. Now that's so changes in ambient air pressure don't cause large distortions in the tympanic membrane.
Ouch!
Let's take a look at the inside of an ear.
Roll the computer graphics.
If someone says,
"Hello, hello,"
that sound enters my head through the ear canal and hits the eardrum, which vibrates when the sound waves hit it. Behind the drum, in the middle ear cavity, are three tiny bones, stirrup, the anvil, and the hammer. They vibrate too and actually amplify the sound. They send the amplified sound vibrations to the cochlea, which looks sort of like a snail. The sound waves travel around and around inside the cochlea and bend over tiny nerve endings called hair cells, much like wind pushes around a field of grain. These hair cells are the ends of nerve cells, and the movement of the hair cells sends electrical signals to the brain. The brain decodes those signals, and I hear...
Hello, it's your mother.
So that's how our hearing works. But what happens when an ear is subjected to hazardous noise? Let's go back to those hair cells. If those hair cells get bent over to the point they can't spring back, that's when hearing loss occurs. It's like these blades of grass. Imagine they're the hair cells in your ears. Now, here comes a moderately loud sound wave. Not bad. The grass bounces back. But when the sound is extremely loud, the hair cells don't spring back. Extremely loud sounds can cause permanent damage. But so can moderately loud sounds if they continue over an extended period of time. See? Remember that blender? long exposures to moderately loud sounds can do just as much harm as one really loud sound. Both situations are hazardous. Fortunately for the lawn, the grass will grow back or it can be replaced. Not so for your ears. The hair cells never grow back, ever, and they can't be replaced. Kind of a drag. So what is hazardous noise?
Have you seen what we'll do to you if you don't speak? Answer me, you fool. What's hazardous noise?
Hazardous noise is defined as any noise louder than 85 decibels that the human ear is exposed to for 8 or more hours. Simply, listening to sounds louder than 85 decibels for long periods of time can cause permanent, lifelong hearing problems. The sound level during a walk in the park averages about 10 to 40 decibels. A washing machine can produce almost 80 decibels of sound. And a jet airplane taking off can produce upwards of 120 decibels or more! Remember, it's not just how loud something is that can damage your hearing. It's also how long you're exposed to it. This blender produces 86 decibels of noise on average. That's just on the edge of the safe limit. Which is okay if you're just making a couple of milkshakes. But if you have to listen to it for 8 hours a day, day after day after day after day, this blender can cause as much hearing damage as standing next to... So who's affected by hazardous noise at work? Probably more occupations than you'd imagine. Check out these average noise exposures. Indoor and outdoor jobs. You might be affected. Unless, of course, you're a librarian. Shh! Don't forget off-the-job noise levels either. Lawnmowers, power tools, firearms, and stereo headsets are just some of the things that produce high noise levels. If you work exposed to loud sounds and play exposed to loud sounds, imagine the results. Really adds up!
What? What was that? So what, I don't hear like I used to. It's just another part of getting older. It's another thing that doesn't work. I don't see so well and I can't smell anymore. Speak up! I'm old.
Being hard of hearing is no joke. It can seriously affect the quality of your life, how you interact with family and friends. It can make you grumpy for a start.
What? What was that?
It can make listening to music less enjoyable. Well, most music. And it can interfere with your ability to communicate. Excuse me.
Hey, down in front.
Hearing Cops, filmed on location with the men and women of audiometric testing.
Let's see how only a mild hearing loss affects communication.
Good afternoon, sir. Can I see your driver's license and registration, please?
You hear that? It's kind of hard to understand. Now let's try it with a moderate hearing loss.
Your driver's license and registration, please, sir.
You see, it's even harder to understand. That's what hearing damage can do to your ability to hear. Now, let's add some background noise. You see how important hearing is? Simple misunderstandings can have unexpected results. What if this were a real emergency? Thanks for the demonstration, officer. We can stop now.
Oh. Demonstration? I always talk this way.
This is Pauline. She's an audiologist. Pauline, how can we tell when the worksite noise level's hazardous?
Well, a simple way to test the noise level is to stand at arm's length from a person and talk to him. If you have to yell or shout to be heard, the level's probably hazardous.
Wow, that is an easy test.
Only if you don't have to shout.
Pauline, how can we tell when our hearing is impaired?
What's scary is that hearing loss can occur so gradually, you may not realize it's happening. The first danger sign is the inability to hear high-pitched sounds. And there's other clues. Over time, sounds may become muffled, or your ears may start to ring. You may notice this, even temporarily, at the end of a workday.
What happens next?
As the damage continues, the loss affects your ability to comprehend speech. Voices become hard to understand. Conversations difficult to follow.
You mean like this?
So now the mid and high-pitched sounds are harder to hear.
Exactly. Eventually you become isolated from the sounds around you. The sounds you take for granted, like music, television, but the sounds you take comfort in, like the voice of family and friends. And sadly, it's a problem for the rest of your life.
So what do we do?
Wear hearing protection. Practice safer listening.
At first, I thought they'd decrease my sensitivity.
But now, I realize they protect it.
It only takes a moment to put them on.
Why take chances? Wear your protection. Sonex by Calvin Klein.
So, how do you choose what hearing protection is best for you? What are the deciding factors concerning you and your job? Well, one consideration should be your current hearing ability.
What?
Also, your exposure to noise
over the whole day.
Your need to communicate on the job.
Sit down.
I don't think there's a circumstance.
Who are you hitting? Oh, you're gone.
Other personal protective equipment you wear. Temperature and climate. The physical constraints of the work activity. And anatomical differences. Once you've chosen the right hearing protection for you, there's only two things to remember. It's fit and it's care. It's essential that your hearing protection fits properly. Let's go to the demonstration tank. It's kind of like this. Imagine, the water is hazardous noise. The drain is your ear, and the stopper is your earplug. If it fits perfectly, the noise stays out. But if you put in a plug that's too small, the noise gets through. Remember those hair cells. It's the same with earmuffs. They have to fit snug too. Just like this stopper. If the seal is broken anywhere, the water or noise will flow in. Watch. Although it takes a while, noise does get through. With so many choices of styles and sizes, it's easy to ensure your hearing protection will be effective. And it won't take long to get used to wearing it.
Just look at all those colors!
Taking care of your hearing protection is easy, too. It's just a matter of cleaning it regularly and inspecting it for damage. If it's damaged, replace it. As part of a program to stop occupational hearing loss in British Columbia, the WCB health and safety regulations require annual hearing tests for workers exposed to hazardous noise. Pauline, what's this all about?
Well, because hearing damage occurs gradually, It could be too late before you notice a problem. A hearing test will help make you aware of a possible loss. It may also reveal other hearing problems.
Where's this testing done?
It may be done where you work. Or a hearing test contractor may come by your worksite in a special van. Or you may be asked to go to a nearby facility.
Now, how's the testing done?
In a test booth. With an audiometric technician.
It works! It works!
Using an audiometer.
Hey, that doesn't look so bad.
That's because all the audiometric technician does is send tones of different pitches to each of your ears. You just respond to them. Then the audiometric technician records the level of the softest sounds you heard on an audiogram, which is just a graph of your hearing ability. Copies of your results are kept so that the audiometric technician can compare them from year to year and advise you of any changes. And it's all confidential.
That looks easy enough.
I'm gonna get a hearing test.
Ooh, that's a great idea. I'm gonna get one too.
Oh good, then we can all go together.
We can't deny it. Hazardous noise exists, both at the work site and away from it. And its effects are serious. Hearing loss is permanent. And with it comes a loss in the quality of life. But it can be prevented. Use hearing protection whenever you're subjected to noise levels over 85 decibels. And make sure your protection is adequate. Remember, the annual hearing test is there to help you in choosing the best hearing protection and monitoring your hearing ability.
Then we can always enjoy what we should never, ever lose.
The Hearing Video.